Good morning, and thank you all for being here today to discuss a very important initiative that we have taken on as a state of Mississippi. Perhaps what Ryan Miller is doing is likely the single most important initiative that is proactive in our state right now with respect to investing in our people and growing our economy. You know, one of the things, and some of you have heard me say this a lot, one of the things that frustrates me the most in government particularly, but just in general, is when I hear the old saying, you know, well, why are we doing this? And the answer comes back, well, that's because that's the way things have always been done. Well, when I hear this saying, alarm bells go off for me, because it essentially means that we're being satisfied with never reaching our full potential. When it comes to workforce development and training in Mississippi, I refuse to allow our state to adopt this mentality. I refuse to allow anything less than accomplishing our full potential. I refuse to, quote, do things simply because that's the way they've always been done. As I've said throughout my entire public service career, one of my top priorities is to make Mississippi the best place in America to live, the best place in America to invest capital and create jobs, the best place in America to work, and ultimately the best place in America to raise a family. To accomplish this goal, we must have a skilled and well-trained workforce. The bedrock of a successful economy lies within a skilled workforce that can adapt to the evolving industry trends and help us attract new businesses. I've been able to, over the last several months, travel to businesses throughout our state that are expanding. I've been able to travel to other places where we're seeing new capital being invested. And we repeatedly hear, first of all, of the strong work ethic that Mississippians have. We hear repeatedly of how important the workforce is to business decisions going forward. And so to get to where we want to ultimately be from a workforce development strategy perspective, it's important to fully understand and appreciate where we find ourselves today. It's imperative that we recognize that it has worked well in the past, but perhaps more importantly, what hasn't worked so well in the past. For our workforce development strategy to be successful, we need to ensure that all of our boats are rowing in the same direction. We need to ensure that all of our partners, such as state agencies, educators, economic developers, and private industry, are singing from the same song thread. We need a focused, coordinated, and well-organized effort that leverages our resources efficiently and effectively. The left hand must know what the right hand is doing. In fact, the left hand first needs to know that the right hand exists. That's why I was proud to sign Senate Bill 2564, which created the Office of Workforce Development, or now commonly known as Accelerate Mississippi. Accelerate Mississippi is going to be crucial in our state's efforts to implement this focused, coordinated, and well-organized strategy. Within the first 6 months, I appointed Patrick Sullivan and several others to the State Workforce Investment Board to assist in overseeing Accelerate Mississippi's creation. I was glad that the board decided to hire Ryan Miller as its first executive director. I can tell you, having worked with Ryan now for a little over 6 months, Mississippi is in good hands with Ryan. You can tell he has a true passion for workforce development and will do everything in his power to ensure Mississippians have what they need to have a successful career right here at home. And Ryan knows he has my full support and the full efforts of the governor's office to help him in that effort. Our teams have been collaborating closely, and I'm extremely pleased with the results over the first 6 months of this initiative. In this short period of time, Accelerate Mississippi has made key hires to its team and assessed the current condition of workforce development strategy throughout our state. While their preliminary findings indicate there has been a success on a micro level, it is also clear that there is room for improvement at the macro level. Some of the areas of improvement include doing a better job informing employers about the workforce development resources available to our people, ensuring that career educational programs are aligned with one another, and providing more clarity regarding the roles our various state agencies play in the workforce development process. Thankfully, we have a plan to address these issues. Way back in 2019, when I campaigned for governor, by the way, it seems like 150 years ago now, but way back in 2019 when I campaigned for governor, I highlighted the need for Mississippi to take a regional approach to workforce development. Moving forward, my administration and Accelerate Mississippi will be dividing the state into 8 regions or ecosystems to meet the unique needs each part of the state. By partnering with communities at the local level, the needs of each individual community can be met in a way that is unique to them based on population, based on geography, based on infrastructure, and of course, yes, based on connectivity. We will also be taking a continuous improvement approach to workforce development. This approach will build upon best practices, improve communication, and enhance collaboration within each of these 8 ecosystems. We will continuously review the actions taken to ensure the state is adequately focusing our resources to make good jobs with above average wages sustainable for our fellow Mississippians, both now and for future generations. Now I'm going to ask Ryan Miller to come up and discuss this approach and some of the other items that I've touched upon here this morning. And then after Ryan comes up, we've got a couple of other speakers that are going to do a fantastic job talking about some of the decisions, the ways in which those decisions are going to impact everyday Mississippians. So with that, Ryan, thank you for being here, and come on up.
Thank you, Governor Reeves. It's a pleasure and a privilege, and I appreciate y'all being here this morning. This is an exciting thing for me, albeit a little bit nerve-wracking, but I'm excited to be here and get to visit with you and to tell you what we've been doing here in the Office of Workforce Development. I want to thank the leadership, certainly the governor's office, lieutenant governor, speaker of the house, and the legislature for having taken the initiative to create this office and to give us a single lens through which to focus all of our efforts in workforce development. 6 months and 2 weeks ago, but no one's counting, I took on this role at April 12th as the executive director. And I can tell you great fear, trepidation, but also great excitement, just the enormity of the job and responsibility. And at that time, and I've heard the governor say it even 3 times this morning, I was told by each person, the governor, lieutenant governor, and speaker of the house, Ryan, the most important issue facing the state of Mississippi is workforce. Talk about getting a little nervous in my shoes at that moment, understanding that it was that important to them. It certainly was and is important to me. I think it's important to all of us. And I want to tell you a little bit about what we've done in the last 6 months. For those of you that know me, I spent almost 13 years at the Center for Manufacturing Excellence, a program that tries to prepare young men and women for careers in manufacturing. And the cornerstone of that program is Kaizen thinking, continuous improvement. Each day we teach students to understand that they are never done improving. There is always room to improve what they do, regardless of whether that's a manufacturing process, an example of standardized work, or even project management. There's always room to improve what you do, to improve the overall quality of the process and invariably the product that you're trying to produce. Same concept applies to us as individuals. There's always room for us to improve. I've brought that same philosophy of Kaizen thinking to Accelerate Mississippi. We are never done improving workforce development in the state of Mississippi. And to do that effectively, you have to understand current condition. If you want to dream up the ideal condition, where you want to go in the future, you better know where you're starting from. And that oftentimes requires you to look in the mirror and have an honest assessment as to who you are and where you've been. At the culmination of this press conference this morning, we will have a report posted that kind of highlights some of the current condition discoveries that we've had over the last 6 months. And let me tell you, I want to start off by prefacing this. We do some amazing things in this state. There are amazing programs scattered around the state that are doing wonderful things for their community, whether you are looking at pre-K, kindergarten, a curriculum at Goshen and Pascagoula, whether you're looking at the Academy of Innovation in Vicksburg, Mississippi, the unbelievable CTE program at Gulfport High School, New Albany, Oxford. There are some amazing programs in our K through 12, amazing programs in our community college system, but you know, we don't really do a good job of telling that story often. We don't really do a good job of sharing best practices with one another, not consistently anyway. There's always room for improvement. And Accelerate Mississippi, as the governor alluded to earlier, has created our 8 ecosystem approach, our ecosystem program. And within each of those ecosystems, we'll have tables set with policy leaders, educators, economic developers, nonprofits who have a passion, a heart, and a mission for helping and being a part of the team. We're going to have our WIO workforce directors who have been tremendous partners thus far. Most importantly, we will have industry members, industry that understands to be part of the solution, they have to be at the table communicating and even putting their own skin in the game. Each of these ecosystems will be tasked and challenged to regularly review 3 pillars, 3 buckets, and you'll see this in the report. Something we call customizable training, which is an approach that we often use for new companies moving to Mississippi or companies existing that want to expand and grow. How can we develop training programs specific to that company's needs? How can we do a better job? How can we improve that? Horizon thinking, the next pillar, next bucket. What are we doing to plan for the careers that aren't even here yet? Do we have the resources in place? Do we have the right curriculum in place? Do we have the right infrastructure to be ready for those technologies and those innovations that will impact our workforce that are on the horizon 15, 20, and even 30 years from now? But what brings us here today is the last bucket, something that we call workforce triage. We have companies who need people, and we have people who need good jobs. How can we do this better? You may have seen here recently that we took the approach of awarding a request for a proposal that we had submitted to our community college partners for Operation Diesel Tech, or a diesel technician and maintenance program. Every year, the state of Mississippi needs over 500 of those professionals in the workforce, and every year we produce a little over 100. There's a deficiency there. Not to mention the fact that those jobs are jobs that pay incredibly well for a limited amount of training. 2 years at Hines Community College, 2 years at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, 2 years at East Mississippi Community College will get you an opportunity to make really good wages, great jobs, and have a meaningful and impactful career. And here with us this morning to talk a little bit about that specific project, we have Dr. Mary Graham from Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, who was the first community college to rise to the challenge and to submit a request, a proposal for Operation Diesel Tech. And I would like for her to take just a few minutes to share some of their perspective as to how this might help the Gulf Coast and the state of Mississippi move forward. Dr. Graham.
Thank you, Brian. Well, I echo the governor's comments and Ryan Miller's comments to thank all of you for being here today. This is exciting news for the state of Mississippi, and I want to commend our governor because this is bold, innovative thinking to redirect limited workforce training dollars for the state of Mississippi in a very strategic way, a very data-driven way, so that we can address the needs of employers. The focus is definitely on employers, but it's also on economic development, the opportunity to lift up Mississippians and to provide a career pathway that not only fills the void for the workplace, but also gives our students, our trainees, an opportunity to train in a high-paying field. So, Governor, thank you. Ryan, thank you. You did a good job naming Ryan. He's really been great to work with. I do want to say that You know, the key to all of this is economic development for the state, and the governor said it so well. We want people to want to live in Mississippi. We want people to invest in Mississippi, and we want to make sure our business, our employers, our industries are thriving and doing well. The only way to make that happen is to provide them with the much-needed workforce, and that's what we intend to do with this new project that we're undertaking at Gulf Coast Community College. From all indications, and Ryan mentioned the report that would be coming out, and you all need to hear that these decisions aren't just made randomly. They're data-driven. They're very much directed toward employer needs, and that's what we're trying to do, address those employer needs. It's a competitive process, which I think is healthy for the state of Mississippi. Rather than just allocating funds to all entities that do training, I think the ecosystem process is very positive. We'll have different needs on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, as they will have different needs in the northern part of the state, and on and on. So I think it's important. The strategy is a good strategy. You all know, and we've said it already, the goal of Accelerate Mississippi is to move more Mississippians into career pathways that lead to good jobs, high-paying jobs, high-demand jobs, and that's what we intend to do. So let me tell you a little bit about what we will do with this grant that we've been awarded at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College. The program is the Heavy Equipment Diesel Maintenance Program. It's a very high-demand area, and you're going to hear a little bit from one of the experts in the field. But what you need to hear from me is that we are cognizant of the needs of employers. We talk to them. They serve on advisory boards. We find out what they need. They help develop curriculum so that it's meeting industry standards, and we make sure that all the credentials the students will receive as a result of this program are industry-recognized credentials. So we make sure the training is in tune to the employer needs. For this program, we'll provide ASE training, MACS certification, Cummins certification, Freightliner training, Caterpillar. Again, we'll be working with industries, Stribling, Empire, the list goes on and on. The one thing that we're going to do different, because we already have started a diesel program and we have a truck driving program, so we're going to consolidate these, give these maintenance mechanics the opportunity not only to train and be a high-paid technician, but they'll also have their truck driving license. They'll have their CDL. So we felt like, as the training entity, we wanted to make them as marketable as possible. So they'll come in and be trained to do the work, but think about, from a very common sense approach, somebody has to drive the truck in, someone has to test drive to make sure it's working properly. So we're going to add that value to that program. We'll expand our advisory committee from 10 to 15. Again, we're located on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, but the reality of it is we're going to train 40 workers in the next year, and they can come from anywhere in Mississippi. We're open to that, and we're willing to train them. The tuition will be free as a part of this grant, so we're excited about that. It will allow us to buy some much-needed equipment to enhance the program that we already had. Several of the pieces of equipment will be trainers. And people say, you know, trainers versus the real equipment. The reality of it is every year the industry standards change. With trainers, you can recalibrate that training system and just upgrade so that you're always on top of what the industry needs. So we intend to do that. We're excited about it. We're excited about the data-driven approach. Numbers matter. Accountability matters. And we're glad to be one of the first community colleges out of the chute. I know my brothers, and I know they're very competitive, so you will see more interest. Community College will step up, as we've always done, to offer that training for business and industry. We want to be a leader in economic development to support everything that's happening with Accelerate Mississippi. And again, the real purpose of all of this is to lift up Mississippians, bring employers to Mississippi, satisfy that pipeline of maybe an aging market. A lot of folks are aging out of these craft positions, so we have to resupply that pipeline. We intend to do it at Gulf Coast. All the community colleges intend to do it, and we appreciate the leadership of our governor and Ryan Miller. Thank you all.
Dr.
Dr. Graham, thank you so much for your words. And at this time, I'd also like to bring up Bob Bullard, who is the service manager for Empire Stribling. This is one such company in the state of Mississippi that, when I was speaking earlier, gets it and understands that they want to be at the table and they want to be part of the solution. They have a need, but they also want to be part of that solution. So, Bob, if you wouldn't mind coming forward and just sharing a few moments of your perspective on this as well, I greatly appreciate that.
Thank you. Governor, I'd like to take a minute to thank you very much for this. This is a big deal to us. It's something we've been needing for years, so thank you very much. Like Ryan said, I'm Bob Bullard with Empire Trucks. I work with Empire and Stribling Equipment. I represent the executive staff, and my responsibility is everything diesel technician. I'm a product of the Mississippi Community College program. I went to the diesel program at Hines, and I represent what's available to the youth out there today of what they can accomplish. These are not jobs. These are careers. These are meaningful careers that will go with them throughout their lifetime. You know, the community college is a starting point for them. When they graduate as employers, we invest a lot more money in them to keep them going. It's a very expensive endeavor for us. And we just can't hire the numbers that we need today. And with this program, we hope to start seeing this thing get traction and start helping us realize our goals, because there's a lot of opportunities out there for the youth in Mississippi. Okay? Thank you.
So in closing for my time, I'll just say thank you, Bob. Thank you, Dr. Graham, for being here. Thank you, Governor. The data-driven approach is important. And moving on from here, we'll be identifying other key industry sectors that have a desperate or emergent need, and community college partners that have programs that, if given additional funds or given additional resources, can help grow those pathways and pipelines. You'll see some of those enumerated in that report. You can find that at acceleratems.org. And again, that report will be made available sometime after this press conference. Again, that's acceleratems.org. I'm grateful for your time, Governor. Thank you so much. I'll turn it back over to you.